Good evening. I'm Kaylina Schnack, your Key Club International President. Welcome to the 2020 Summer Leadership Conference Recognition Session. Tonight, we recognize and celebrate the outstanding efforts to serve and lead throughout the 2019-2020 year. We have come so far since this time last year, and your Key Club membership is a unique experience that deserves recognition. While this year's spring season limited our opportunities for celebration, we have noticed your hard work and would like to take an opportunity to share with all of Key Club International. So sit back, relax, grab your popcorn, and enjoy the show.
Hello, I'm Caitlin Cirillo, your Key Club International Vice President. Key Club International Contest will be different due to the cancellation of Key Club International Convention 2020. And unfortunately, almost all of them are canceled. All winners from the district level will be honored during this recognition ceremony. For the iconic Key Club poster contest, there will be an opportunity for all Summer Leadership Conference attendees to vote for the winning Key Club poster on the official conference app. Be sure to download the Kiwanis Family Events app to vote for your favorite poster. The Key Club poster is a timeless way to recruit new members, educate members on the values and objectives of Key Club, and is also an opportunity for our talented members to illustrate their creativity and spirit. The contest is divided into two categories, digital and non-digital. Let's see what you submitted this year. Nice to see such creative work coming from our Key Clubs. Don't miss the chance to vote for the winning poster on the Kiwanis Family Events app.
Hi everyone, I'm Rachel Zhang, your Key Club International Trustee, and here to present the Robert F. Lucas Outstanding Lieutenant Governor Awards. By naming the Robert F. Lucas Award several years ago, Key Club sought to honor a man who served Key Club International for more than 20 years. This award recognizes lieutenant governors who have shown extraordinary leadership and caring in ways that propel them to a level of excellence above the rest.
Please join me in congratulating the Robert F. Lucas Outstanding Lieutenant Governor Award recipients for the 2019-2020 year.
From the Alabama District. From the California, Nevada, Hawaii District. From the Capital District. From the Caribbean Atlantic District. From the Carolinas District. From the Eastern Canada District. From the Florida District. From the Illinois Eastern Iowa District. From the Indiana District. From the Jamaica District. From the Kansas District. From the Kentucky-Tennessee District. From the Louisiana-Mississippi-Western Tennessee District. From the Michigan District. From the Nebraska-Iowa District. From the New England and Bermuda District. From the New Jersey District. From the New York District. From the Ohio District. From the Pacific Northwest District. From the Pennsylvania District. From the Rocky Mountain District. From the Southwest District. From the Texas-Oklahoma District. From the Wisconsin-Upper Michigan District. Congratulations to each of our outstanding Lieutenant Governors.
Our diversity of heritage, personality, and leadership contributes to the beautiful culture of Key Club. How have the unique qualities of our truly international organization shaped you and your impact on your community? Key Club International would like to thank every Key Clubber for using their talents and passion to lead and be a voice for their communities. This year, there were two submissions from the Rocky Mountain District and the New England and Bermuda District. We would like to recognize these Key Clubbers for using their passion and their voice by playing these videos for you now. This oratorical entry comes from Isaac Armejo Ponce from Riverton High School Key Club, Rocky Mountain District.
Fairly recently, I was asked the question, "Do you love me?" Under the circumstances, you could answer that question in many ways if context is not given, to which I ultimately responded, "Of course not. You stole my ice cream bar." To this, I told my sister, whom I love dearly, despite her taking my frozen dessert. In another circumstance, I was asked, "Do you love me?" To which I responded to that glimmering mirror, "Of course I do, you handsome devil." And in another, I was asked, "Do you love me?" To which I responded, "I love you more than words can express." Love is a simple four-lettered word, but there can be so much meaning behind it when we use it or when it is directed to us. I feel like the same could be said for service. When you speak of faith and spirituality, divine service comes to mind. When you speak of protection and pride, military service comes to mind. And let's not forget the true heroes that have stepped up to help serve this pandemic. Domino's Delivery Service. Indeed, there have been a plethora of people that have stood up, including medical personnel, grocery and produce workers, and of course, those lovely delivery men and women, to which we all thank you greatly. I want to acknowledge that these people don't wear capes, and most of their names are not known. But I believe that these people know that they are aiding to something way, way bigger than themselves. And this is what I'm reminded of when I think of the past projects that I've worked with in my Key Club. Our club is definitely small, and so is our community, but we gladly take on projects that make us bite off a little more than we can chew. But we have a sense of pride in that, because we are small, but definitely mighty. And all of these projects have been set on the back burner due to the current state our world is in, but I am happy to say that Key Club's ideals have not left me, and I encourage you to keep them close in your heart as well, because when a global issue like the one that we are experiencing today reaches these levels, it is not just up to dispatchers and to law enforcers to resolve every issue. It is up to us as well. And by no means is Key Club a small organization. Ranging from Alaska to Australia, there's an estimated 270,000 members aspiring to commit to service. And we can resolve these issues in small ways. And it strikes me with awe. Young men and women from all walks of life striving to become better through service. And I truly believe that even with our circumstances, service will undoubtedly pierce through. And I am aware that our services might not be as grand as those of researchers or of doctors, but we can definitely start small. Lending your neighbor some sugar, helping your mom bake a cake, and of course, respecting your teacher's Zoom hours. Some other noteworthy heroes. Because as Key Clubbers, we know that service is pure. And just like my hometown's Key Club, our efforts might not match those of a densely populated one, but we know that all service, just like love, is acceptable now more than ever. And when the world is in such a scary place that it is now, it takes a team of people to lift it back on its feet, of Kiwanians, of Key Clubbers, of a unified people. In a sense, I am reminded of that African proverb that says, "It takes a whole village to raise one child." Our world is this beautiful, fragile child that we must care and nurture to grow. That includes our communities, our parks, our families, our neighbors that might just need a cup of sugar to be placed on their porch. And that is the beauty of community service. That in all acts of it, no action is too small. From the confines of your home, I truly hope that the ideals of Key Club have not left your minds. Relying on these simple acts of kindness and service have currently replaced those larger scale projects that you guys might have set in mind. And that's okay. Because if Key Club has taught us anything, and that is to help. Help is another one of those words that can mean so much when we use it. But it is truly up to us to choose how we act upon it. So best we do it for something good. I hope all of you are well. Thank you.
Next, we have an oratorical entry from Sam Alkali of Kennett High School Key Club in the New England and Bermuda District.
Do you remember your first day of high school? What was it like? And more importantly, how did you feel? Hundreds, if not thousands, of kids, all coming from different backgrounds, carrying different stories, gathering in one building to learn. To most, it's unbearably overwhelming. I know it felt like that for me. For the first few months of school, sports proved to be my outlet, but I desperately needed something more, something that would build my character and shape my outlook on the world. Unbeknownst to me, the solution to this all too familiar problem was sitting right in front of my face the entire time. Every Monday throughout the fall, I watched kids leave my golf practice early to go to their Key Club meeting. This piqued my interest, but at first I was simply too afraid to act on it. After months of wrestling with my anxiety, I finally decided to go to my first meeting in January of my freshman year. On that fateful day, I arrived at the school promptly at 5 p.m. and slipped into the meeting room just in time to hear the words, "I pledge on my honor to uphold the objects of Key Club International." I was stunned to look upon the faces of over 100 students listening to this one girl in front of the room. That girl, I would go on to learn, was the eloquently spoken valedictorian of the senior class and Key Club president. She was also, from my perspective, an unlikely leader. Before going to my first Key Club meeting, the vast majority of leaders I had been exposed to were the strongest, most athletic members of my sports teams. In my freshman eyes, it was almost incomprehensible to see a leader like that. How could someone who wasn't the biggest, strongest, or loudest person command so much attention? Well, Key Club would soon teach me. The meeting lasted an hour, but it went by in the blink of an eye. And when I reopened them, they were looking upon a whole other world. Just an hour before, I had no knowledge of any charitable organizations within the valley, but after, I knew about wonderful places like Camp Sunshine and KPTI. After the meeting was over, I spoke with Barry Chisholm and joined on the spot. In ensuing years, Barry, our club's advisor, would blossom into one of my essential high school role models. It started with my participation in events for some locally based foundations like Believe in Books, and soon branched off into fundraisers for more national foundations like Camp Sunshine. Throughout the spring, I amassed over 20 hours, a tenfold increase from the 2 I had in 8th grade. And while neither of those numbers may seem substantial, those were 20 of the most important hours of my life. They served as a catalyst for my future in Key Club and allowed me to venture outside of my comfort zone each time I went to an event. From selling raffle tickets on a train weaving through the mountains on a crisp fall day, to auctioning off pies at a Kiwanis banquet on a frigid winter night, each event added a new sense of perspective to my life. A sense of caring and inclusiveness that were once foreign to me started to become like second nature, and I'm better off because of it. Over the next 2 years, I would go on to amass well over 200 hours of community service, take a giant leap out of my comfort zone by volunteering at Camp Sunshine. It was unbelievable to meet families from different cities with different stories be united by one like tragedy and move forward from it. From big events like staying up all night with a group of rowdy tweens in a baking gymnasium, to small ones like playing ping pong with a little girl who had just been dropped off in the game room for the first time, I put forth all of my effort to be the sunshine that would clear the clouds on their dreary day. Key Club made that possible. Key Club also made it possible for me to become one of the first members and eventually vice president of We Dive Together, a club that preaches caring and inclusiveness by sitting with kids who are alone in the cafeteria. Through We Dine Together, I have met a diverse cast of people and eliminated over 60 lunches where someone didn't have a friend. At least 60 more look to be in my future. These organizations have shown me that compassion and love are infinitely more important to possess than any ribbons or trophies from a sport. They have given me purpose throughout my high school years, expanded my impact within my community, and most importantly, shaped my view of the world in which we live today. When I look back upon that shy and overwhelmed freshman from the past, I realize there are only fleeting glimpses of him today. He has changed, and now, caring is his way of life.
Thank you to Isaac and Samuel for using your voices to interpret our core values.
Good evening, Key Clubbers. I'm Indigo Parlin, Key Club International Trustee, and I'm here to present our Single Service Awards. The Key Club International Single Service Awards recognizes the most outstanding individual projects performed by Key Clubs during the past year. This year, we would like to recognize all of our Key Club International clubs that achieved this honor. In the bronze division, with 35 members or fewer. In the silver division, with 36 to 60 members. In the gold division, with 61 to 85 members. And finally, in the platinum division, with 86 members or more. Congratulations, and thank you for serving your homes, schools, and communities. Now, let's look at a few of this year's Key Club recruitment videos. One of several contests showcasing clubs' imagination and abilities is the Club Video Contest. Tonight, we get the chance to view three innovative videos that are the best of their districts. In the following orders, we will show you videos from Danbury High School Key Club of the New England and Bermuda District, Delaney High School Key Club of the Capital District, and Chapel Hill High School of Georgia District. These Key Clubbers have done a wonderful job, and we hope you enjoy their hard work.
Welcome to the world of Key Club, where magic can be found in the smiles of volunteers, to the way they help out in the community from cleaning up parks, working in community gardens, helping kids, and more. Key Club is an organization with over 3,000 clubs in 38 countries. Danbury High School Key Club has more than 150 members. We value leadership, character building, caring, and inclusiveness, and we tend to have a little fun too. Here at DHS, we strive to exhibit these values in everything that we can do. We find the interest in our members and build committees around their interests, from scrapbooking, fundraising, membership recruitment, and even decon. Everywhere you look, as if they're casting a spell, you can find Key Club members all over town helping their community. And with the little magic they use, they achieve things as volunteers we never thought were possible.
This is Danbury High School's Key Club page. Thank you for visiting. Can we start over?
If I had to describe Key Club in one word, it would be fun.
Inspiring. Service.
Okay. Organized. Friends. Educational.
Productive.
Enjoyable.
Rewarding.
Outstanding.
Beautiful.
Meaningful.
Adventurous.
Inspiring.
Valiant. Devotional.
Helpful. Opportunity.
Service. Fun.
Happiness.
Uplifting.
Exciting.
Family.
Community.
Key Club is motivation.
Key Club is just a great place to be.
You kept me out of trouble because I'm so busy.
I wanted to say community, but somebody in the video already said that.
Helping others is the Key Club way. So why don't you join Key Club today?
Good evening, I'm Conrad Gabriel, Key Club International Trustee, here to present the Major Emphasis Award winners. From fundraising for our service partners to mentoring our children, the Major Emphasis unite Key Clubbers around one cause, improving the lives of children around the world. Congratulations to our Major Emphasis Award winners. Up next, I'd like to recognize the distinguished clubs and distinguished diamond clubs from the 2019-2020 year. Consistent club administration, strong membership, continued leadership development, Kwan's family involvement, valuable fundraising, and above all, outstanding service. These are the standards of excellence that make up the distinguished diamond clubs. Congratulations to all.
From the California Nevada Hawaii District, from the Caribbean Atlantic District, from the Carolinas District, from the Florida District, from the Georgia District, from the Illinois Eastern Iowa District, from the Jamaica District, from the Kansas District, from the Kentucky Tennessee District, from the New England and Bermuda District, from the New Jersey District, from the New York District, from the Minnesota Dakotas District, from the Pacific Northwest District, from the Southwest District, from the Texas-Oklahoma District.
Hello again, Caitlin here. Let's take a moment to honor our outstanding advisors. From first-time advisors to those who have served for decades, the individuals recognized as outstanding faculty advisors to Key Clubs have many things in common. They are dedicated, selfless, and are true believers in student-led experiences. These outstanding faculty advisors are mentors to their Key Club members and are committed to fostering student leaders. Outstanding Kiwanis advisors for Key Club are recognized for giving their time and resources endlessly. With their vast community contacts, these Kiwanis advisors help their Key Club members with new ideas and achieving club goals. The outstanding Kiwanis advisors are open-minded, supportive, and dedicated, and are also looked up to as role models. Please be sure to check out keyclub.org/awards after this session to see a list of who these amazing advisors are. And Key Clubbers, I encourage you to thank them personally by sending a thank you email, a thank you note, or giving them a shout out at your next Key Club meeting. Thank you so much for your dedication and service.
Key Clubbers have supported UNICEF's program to eliminate maternal and neonatal tetanus, MNT for short, a vaccine-preventable disease, since 2010. This disease affects the most vulnerable, hardest-to-reach mothers and babies in the world. It's a terrible disease. Any light, sound, or touch will cause excruciating pain to the newborn baby, which often means the mother and family can only watch as the baby suffers. The mom can't even pick up or hug her baby to comfort them. But with your great work, UNICEF has been able to vaccinate so many mothers before they give birth, so their babies would not have to go through these terrible symptoms. This year, Key Clubbers have raised over $223,000. This money has allowed UNICEF to reach over 70,000 women with the tetanus vaccine, protecting them and all their future children. Thanks to your support, this year, the Democratic Republic of Congo eliminated MNT, which means there are only 12 countries left in the entire world where babies are at risk of contracting tetanus. Through the partnership with UNICEF, Key Clubbers are having real impact on the lives of families all around the world. We've raised over $6 million since 2010, and we won't stop now. In 2015, the Key Club International Board made a pledge to raise $3 million in 5 years. We're almost there. We only have $490,000 left to raise. Let's keep going to fulfill this promise that we made to the most vulnerable families in the world. We can and will continue to do our part to protect children and families worldwide. The
Distinguished District Awards recognize the outstanding officers whose hard work and enthusiasm keep the district's Key Club thriving. Their hard work and dedication are needed for continued district success. From the Alabama District, Luke Reed, Distinguished Governor. Basim Naim, Distinguished Secretary. From the California-Nevada-Hawaii District, Chofan Yu, Distinguished Governor. Christy Poon, Distinguished Treasurer. Hannah Shi, Distinguished Editor. From the Capital District, Pamela Barrett, Distinguished Governor. From the Caribbean Atlantic District, Ariana Lane, Distinguished Governor. Anisha Bradshaw, Distinguished Secretary. Elon Greenidge, Distinguished Secretary Treasurer. Zakiah Downs, Distinguished Editor. From the Carolinas District, Colby Lovelace, Distinguished Governor. Adam Horn, Distinguished Secretary. Gabby Tucker, Distinguished Editor. Raghav Chari, Distinguished Treasurer. From the Eastern Canada District, Hannah Zimogrodzki, Distinguished Governor. Janice Liang, Distinguished Editor. From the Florida District, Star DeHaiti, Distinguished Governor. William Ahn, Distinguished Editor. Alexander Garcia, Distinguished Webmaster. From the Illinois Eastern Iowa District, Allison Deng, Distinguished Treasurer. From the Indiana District, Emma Brainerd, Distinguished Governor. From the Jamaica District, Thaslima Nukrama, Distinguished Governor. Stephanie Troncoso, Distinguished Secretary Treasurer. From the Kansas District, Kylie Jenkins, Distinguished Governor. From the Kentucky-Tennessee District, Ashley Song, Distinguished Governor. From the Louisiana-Mississippi-West Tennessee District, Max Haley, Distinguished Governor. From the Michigan District, Eliana Hussein, Distinguished Governor. Preston Piranha, Distinguished Secretary. River Pease, Distinguished Editor. From the Nebraska-Iowa District, Hannah Huang, Distinguished Governor. Kylie Egbert, Distinguished Editor. From the Montana District, Aiden Bash, Distinguished Governor. From the New England and Bermuda District, Grace Jarrell, Distinguished Secretary. Ava Jarrell, Distinguished Editor. From the New Jersey District, Emma Key, Distinguished Governor. Katrina Pham, Distinguished Secretary. Sarah Jacob, Distinguished Editor. Jillian Bain, Distinguished Treasurer. From the New York District, Camille Brock, Distinguished Governor. Lena Chung, Distinguished Secretary. Angela Lontoc, Distinguished Editor. Anthony Lim, Distinguished Treasurer. Angela Lontoc, Outstanding District Officer. From the Pacific Northwest District, Justin England, Distinguished Governor. Allison Hahn, Distinguished Editor. Katie Sell, Distinguished Treasurer. Pranav Gundrala, Distinguished Webmaster. From the Pennsylvania District, Michele Mazurkovich, Distinguished Governor. From the Southwest District, Ella Erickson, Distinguished Governor. David Lopez Amaya, Distinguished Secretary Treasurer. Eric Samala, Distinguished Editor. From the Utah-Idaho District, Carson Moore, Distinguished Governor. From the Rocky Mountain District, Jordan Reichhart, Outstanding District Officer. From the Texas-Oklahoma District, Ashna Patel, Distinguished Governor. Karina Patel, Distinguished Secretary. Vivian Tai, Distinguished Editor. Congratulations, Distinguished Officers.
Congratulations, Distinguished Officers. Now, onto our Key of Honor. The Key of Honor Award is the most prestigious honor bestowed by the Key Club International Board. This award recognizes individuals who have gone beyond the call of duty and dedicating their energy to serving the youth of our nations. This year, we have the honor of adding one individual to this group of outstanding volunteers. Before we announce this person's name, I'd like to tell you a little bit about them. This year's recipient embodies the spirit of the Kiwanis organization in everything she does, and been described as the person who is the glue that helps form a tight district board. She has been a mentor, a friend, an advisor, and an inspiration to countless members of the Kiwanis family. This year's honoree has been described as an exceptional advisor who strives to promote the Key Club core values of leadership, character building, caring, and inclusiveness. While ascending to various leadership positions, she has continually provided support for others. One former Kiwanis District Governor remarked this year's honoree, "continues to give her time and efforts to support those around her without ever asking for anything in return." This person understands the importance of inspiring others while consistently going above and beyond the call of duty to make an impact on those that they surround. A former Key Club member said, "She's an inspirational friend who has taken on numerous initiatives that have helped youth leaders and Kiwanians alike. Her selflessness nature has a trickle-down effect, as leaders of all walks of life can look to her as a great example of servant leadership." This year's honoree has gone above and beyond the call to service, providing opportunities and advice for Key Club members long after graduation. One Kiwanian said, "Key Club members look up to her as a role model and community builder. She's a gentle guide and lets the leaders lead." This person has consistently been a pivotal leader in the lives of those she's helped, mentoring not only students, but adults as well. For more than two decades, this person has played important leadership roles in both Kiwanis and Key Club, while also being dedicated to enriching the lives of others throughout her community. Please join me in congratulating this year's Key of Honor recipient from the Eastern Canada District, Shelley DeCotes. And lastly, today's announcements. Don't forget that you can vote for your favorite poster using the Kiwanis Family Event app. We will announce the winner at tomorrow's closing session at 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Make sure to watch for any additional updates to the schedule on the app as well. Tomorrow, Kenneths will attend the nominating conference to narrow our final Key Club International Board ballot. Good luck, candidates! And this concludes our recognition session. Thank you so, so much for tuning in. We'll see you tomorrow at the closing session. Have a good evening!